That's a great idea. I like it. We've never done anything about small space gardens. That's perfect. Thank you so much for calling. Getting to work on it right away. Great. Thanks. Small space. Perfect. Small space garden. We need patio furniture. Shoot, that's not going to work. Hardscape elements. No. Okay, this is going to be a problem.
Billy.
Plant material.
Billy.
Owen.
Hey, we got to do some gardening.
Yeah, I think so.
Hiya.
What are you doing? Well, I just got a phone call from a viewer, and they thought maybe it would be good to do a show about small space gardens. We really haven't covered that, so I'm making a small space garden. Yeah.
It's not going to work.
No, I don't
Billy,
think so.
Look, it's bad television, and it's not going to work because you're never going to get the plant in there, right? Okay, so look, I got an idea. Why don't we actually go out, find some actual locations of small space gardens, and do a show that shows people how it works. So,
sweet.
For example, we could do like a balcony.
Mm-hmm.
We could do a condo patio.
Yeah, that's small
space.
We
could do a parkway.
Yeah.
Or like a 20 by 20 smaller space in a bigger space, like the Garden Wise Guys.
Oh, right. Like when you
break it, garden,
right.
Break it down. And you know what I'm thinking is, like, the thing is, the small spaces are special because they have to be very, very finely tuned, attention to detail. Everything has to look right. It's like a room. Everything has to be nice. You can't have junk around like you can sometimes in a bigger garden and get away with it. And the plants have to be the right size. And you have to think about function, like how things actually work, because everything has to do something.
Yeah.
Create shade, place to eat, whatever. We could show people so many things.
Oh, great idea. Okay, so why don't we, like, gather up all our stuff, our Garden Wise Guys tool belt, and just get out of here, okay?
No. Okay, let's see.
I'll get the tool belt, Garden Wise Guys tool.
Okay.
Never know. Might have to make some croissants or something. Cultivators are good because, you know, small space.
Let's take two, just in case.
Take two. Never know when they'll come in.
And the
in
whisk.
Handy.
Don't forget the whisk.
Ah, might have to make a souffle. Perfect. And the brush.
I'll take the...
Okay. We can leave the rest of this. Come back for it.
Let's go.
Oh, cool, look, a balcony.
Oh, yeah,
perfect.
It's kind of small and sad looking. I think you could use our help.
Yeah, and, you know, we've got all the conditions. There's no soil up there, limited space.
Yeah?
Cool. I'll go knock on the door, see if somebody's home.
Don't worry about it. I got this Batman trick.
Well,
watch this.
What?
No, seriously. Check this out. Okay. See, we're just going to do that, and then I'm just going to...
Tell you what, I don't like climbing. If you're going to be Batman, I'll be Wolverine.
Whatever.
Okay. Oh man, the things we go through to get people to create sustainable gardens. Oh, and this is getting. Oh great, now I got an itch. Okay, wait a minute. Okay, wait. Oh, jeez. Well, I hope we get combat.
You doing okay?
Here, yeah. Hold on to these. Do we get combat pay for this or stunt?
No, I'm afraid
we're
not.
We're supposed to have stunt doubles.
Look at this.
So where are we? This is like,
bleak.
What, about 5 by...
5 by tiny.
Five by tiny.
It's a technical term.
Okay.
Yeah.
Constraints. What are we looking at here? West
Beautiful
exposure.
Beautiful view. Nice view.
Fabulous.
West exposure, which means what? Afternoon sun.
Hot in the afternoon.
That's going to be an issue.
Right. So both from the comfort of somebody sitting out here, as well as how the plants are going to grow, take the sunlight into consideration. You may not have afternoon sun. Might be all shade.
Yeah.
Right.
And what are we going to do with this? I mean, it's so small. Badminton?
There's no
shuffleboard?
Shuffleboard's good. Real short range.
Maybe chess or checkers.
Now you're thinking.
Yeah.
Not very
Tiny
well.
Tiny table.
But you're thinking. There's no soil up here. This is a, you know, upstairs balcony, so the pots.
Yeah, it's a clay. Let me see here. It's a clay pan, isn't it? Yeah.
No, it's more like stucco. So you got to think, everything you want to grow has got to go in pots, whether they're on the ground, hanging pots, wall-mounted pots. That'll take care of the green.
And the pot thing, you know, is difficult because there really aren't any plants that are native to pots, and so things don't really like to be in pots.
Right.
This is where the succulent aspect of it comes in, because it's a warm, sunny spot, and you could do really well with succulents here, and they're really easy in pots.
The other thing is it doesn't take a lot of water. These plants are small, so one of the bonuses, water-conserving garden, if you keep them in pots, good stuff.
Yeah.
What about how you use this space? I like to think of a small space like this as the equivalent of an indoor room. So this is a place where you might want to sit and read a book.
Mm-hmm.
You could have a little cafe table, just big enough for a couple of people.
Mm-hmm.
Or maybe it does double duty. Comfortable enough to sit in. Also a chair that you can sit and enjoy a meal.
Yeah, it'll probably have to, but that's okay.
Okay,
comfortable furniture, small. It's sustainable. It's so small, you can't use up very many resources.
That's true. Here. It's pretty easy. Yeah. We should try to find something a little bit bigger.
Yeah?
Yeah. Oh, you know
nice.
What? That little courtyard. Isn't
down
below
there.
Little courtyard. Yeah,
yeah, I saw that.
Geez, the house is locked. We can't get through.
So?
I guess I'm...
Just jump.
Jump?
Yeah, why not? It's not that far.
Okay,
far.
I'll just jump.
Billy, no! It was just you! I'm coming!
Ah!
Woohoo! Look out, Billy! Here I come!
Yeah. Whew, boy. Billy, is that you? Billy, what happened? What? What did?
I don't know. I fell head first. Something broke my foot.
Something's not right.
Something's not right. What in the world?
Pull!
Wait a minute!
Oh!
Okay. What have you gotten yourself into?
That's not my hat. No, that's fine. Hey!
Well, we found ourselves a patio anyway.
Yeah, we got a small patio.
It's small.
What is going on out here? It's the Garden Wise Guys! Oh! Hi,
hey.
I'm Dana.
Hi, Dana. How you doing?
Hi, Nice to meet
Owen.
You.
Yeah.
I have to say, thanks for the great customer service.
Are you the one who called this morning? That phone call I was on, that was you,
that was
right?
me.
The person who wanted us to do a show on small space
gardening.
Oh,
yeah. Well, yeah. We just thought we'd drop in, you know.
Yeah.
It's so great. I never expected that.
Well, whatever
we're here for.
You know? Well, so what do you need?
Well, actually, got my list right here.
Yeah.
I'm pretty organized. The first thing, seating. I'd love to have people over, and right now I have nowhere to sit. Girls for book club, maybe some tea in the afternoons. The second thing, plants. I really don't have anything right now. I'd love to be able to grow veggies, maybe a coconut tree if we can do it. I love the milk. It is so good for the complexion. The next thing is it gets so hot out here at certain times of the day. I mean, the temperature is up and down. Can we create some dappled shade or something? I don't know. I wanted to hear your ideas. I know you guys are experts, so I'm really looking forward to that.
Well, that's all pretty reasonable stuff. In terms of space and what you do with this, it's not a luxurious amount of space here, but you've got about 12 by 12. That should be enough for a table that seats four and still maybe like a little fireplace, one of those portable chimeneas, and maybe even a little spot for a fountain, a little focal point. So I think you can get all that out of it.
That sounds great.
Yeah.
Now, as far as the plants go, Dana, I don't know about the coconut tree. That's kind of a big tree. We'll have to talk about that. You can definitely have a fruit tree somewhere in the corner here. Have to think about what you like to eat. Lots of perennials, flowering plants, other things that create food, things that attract beneficial insects. Get some vines on these fences, or you know, even do a vertical garden. Vertical gardens are all the rage right now.
And you know, to cool it off, you're east facing, so you know, it's, later in the afternoon it'll be a little bit better. But you can always get a table that has an umbrella. That's one way to go. Also, you can rig shade cloth attractively, or you might just place that fruit tree so it casts a little bit of shade. In the corner, so I think you can have it all.
That sounds so great. But whatever we do, I just want to make sure that it's sustainable and we don't use a lot of water. I really want to do my part.
Absolutely, yeah. And water conservation is totally important. Your fruit tree is going to use a little bit of water, but it's probably not that much, and of course you're offsetting water use somewhere else on a farm where you would have bought the fruit from the grocery store. The rest of the plants can be drought tolerant. There's really no problem with that.
Yeah, and also, you know, it's a small garden. You're not going to use that much, but it's great that you're thinking about it. A little layer of mulch, low water using plants. I think you're good.
So, Dana, I hope this has been helpful. It's been a lot of fun, and we'd love to stick around, but we have a little bigger garden that we have to go see right now.
Yeah,
so
one question, could we, like, just take a cab or walk or
definitely.
Something?
Oh,
like
absolutely cab, not. I've got this taken care of.
Oh, cool.
Come in, Chopper One. We need a pickup over here at Alpha 5 Sector B, pronto.
No, this isn't going to be good. No, you know, okay, well, what the hell? We'll talk to you later. Okay.
Bye.
Hi, I'm Kathy. I'm with the City of Santa Barbara's Water Conservation Department, and we're talking about what you can do to eliminate the excess watering and to have a beautiful, beautiful landscape. Today our focus is on the park strip, that little strip of land between the street and the sidewalk. Basically, it's a container plant. It's difficult to water. It's narrow. The sprinklers throw into the street. They throw onto the sidewalk. And most people in the past have all had turf grass or lawn out here. It's not a recreational lawn. It's pretty much the neighborhood dog park. And it's not very efficient. One of the things that we're looking at today on this park strip, gosh, it used to all be lawn. And so every week they'd have to come out and mow it. You always had cleanup duties and whatnot. And now look at it. We've got 3-4 different kinds of plants. There's mulch down here. There's permeable walkways, so when people get out of a car, there's something to step on. What they've done is they've changed the sprinkler nozzle to be this nice low flow rotating nozzle that's specifically designed for a park strip. It waters 4 feet out and 15 feet wide instead of 6 feet all the way around. So if you're looking for more information, visit sbwater.org. We're here to help you. We'd love to see your garden beautiful and water-wise.
Exciting.
I've never been in a helicopter before.
We've slid down power poles coming by helicopter. This exciting
really
show.
Fun show. Yeah.
Hey, we're at Garden Wise Guys headquarters, and this is a great example, I think, of how we've taken a large garden and broken it down into a series of smaller rooms.
Yeah, and you know, this used to be this horrible lawn with a bunch of dog holes in it and this rusty chain link fence, and it was really awful. So everything you see is starting from scratch, ground zero.
Yeah. Why don't we take a look first at, we've got a fountain here that adds a little bit of sound and kind of cools the air. Hey, we're in the entryway of Garden Wise Guys headquarters, and we have this fountain here. It's a nice focal point as people come in from the gate. Makes a pleasant sound, so it masks some of the sound of traffic. It's water conserving because all this water just recirculates, and we've got it on a solar-powered pump, so no electricity, and it even provides some habitat.
Oh, and that's so cool, and there's the dragonflies and the birds. Remember the time that egret came and landed right there? It had this like, 6-foot wingspan. It was so amazing.
Very cool. Yeah.
Okay, so I'm going to go set up the dining room table thing that we talked about.
Yeah.
You want to come with me and help out?
I got a little bit of laundry to do. You know, we've got the water, so.
Okay, well, come when you're ready.
Okay,
talk to you later.
Yeah.
Oh, this is nice. What's better than eating outside, huh? And you know, this space really has everything. Table, chimney to keep warm, a beautiful tree overhead for shade, adobe walls all around for privacy. It's peaceful, it's quiet. And you know, it's a fairly small space. It's only like 10 by 10, but we've got a table for four here to sit and have a nice elegant dinner. I mean, how could it get any better than this?
Are you okay with the Merlot? Is that gonna be all right?
It's all right.
Okay. Too early?
No, it's 9 o'clock in the morning. That's after 5.
Oh, that's true. Okay. I thought maybe I'd talk a little bit about planting strategies in a small garden. There's a lot you need to think about, but it's really pretty easy. Come on. Just a little. We have some driving.
Yeah. Okay. I know.
When you have a large space and you want to subdivide it into two different rooms, best thing you can do is have a couple of vertical elements that act like a gateway. On my right, I have Mexican weeping bamboo, wonderful lacy plant, and on my left is giant bird of paradise. They give you a strong vertical element, two separate spaces, perfect way to go.
Okay, so here's a really great example of how you can use just a few container plants in a very small space to create a really beautiful little design. We've got a vertical element with this hanging donkey tail, various other succulents, high, low. It only takes up like 3 by 3 feet, and it works really beautifully. By the way, succulents are the absolute best thing to have in a container because they don't need much water, they don't need much fertilizer, and they will last in containers for years. This thing has been in here for probably 10 or 12 years. It works really great. Okay, so another thing we have here at Garden Wise Guys headquarters is lots and lots of food. In fact, there's over 130 varieties of food growing on this property. The spaces aren't real big, but they're bigger than the other places we've looked at, and it's easy to start growing a lot of diversity. Lettuce, broccoli, artichokes, kale, potatoes. These are easy plants to grow. They don't take up much room, and they're really, really cool, and they're delicious too, by the way. Maybe we should look at some of the other stuff that we've got around here. What do you think? Oranges?
Avocados.
Kale.
Bananas.
Lemons.
Rosemary.
Okay, we all know how important compost is for returning nutrients to the soil, recycling plant material, saving water. But you might think that in a small space, you haven't got room for a big compost pile. Check this out. These things can be purchased from the County of Santa Barbara for a really huge discount. They're made from recycled plastic, and they work great. They're just super.
Yeah. Hey, you know, we've been talking about a lot of theoretical stuff and giving you some ideas, but what say we go to a nursery and see if we can actually create a small space garden?
I'm up for that, but I got one condition.
What's that?
Well, the calisthenics with the helicopters and then jumping off.
Yeah, that's a little scary.
I've had enough of that.
Okay.
Can we just take the bus or something?
I just got a new app. Let me see where... Oh. Time Warp 2. Painless, I promise.
Okay. Hey, how would you like to get paid to install sustainable landscaping? Drip irrigation? Mulch, and drought-tolerant plants. It sounds too good to be true, doesn't it? Well, it actually is true. Here's what you do. Go to sbwater.org or check with your local water purveyor to find out about Santa Barbara County's Smart Landscape Rebate Program. Free money to do landscaping. I mean, how cool is that?
Hey, one of the most popular things in gardening these days are vertical gardens. You could do it with ornamental plants, or you can do it with even edible plants. But in this case, it's a great solution for a small space garden. If you don't have a lot of stuff, a lot of space on the ground, you just stack the plants up. These are a very unusual type of plant. This is beautifully done using bromeliads and tillandsias. Those are epiphytic plants that normally grow in the debris and the bark that falls into the crotches of trees and jungles and stuff. Orchids grow that way. Anyway, this is a gorgeous way to do it. There's just small pots that are tucked in here, and this just gets a light misting every once in a while. Partial shade, grows beautifully.
You know, one of the really great strategies for a small space is vines. This is a beautiful vine called Giant Burmese Honeysuckle, and it's one of, I don't know, dozens, maybe hundreds of different vines that work really well in our climate. Now, vines do all sorts of things. They will clamber on a fence or a wall. They don't take up a lot of room. They provide flowers, fruit, sometimes edible fruit. In this case, they're actually casting shade over the south side of the house, which means that the microclimate is a lot more agreeable than it would be if it was out in the full sun. The branching structure is beautiful. Everything about it is really nice. Now, the one thing you have to keep in mind is that you do have to trim vines, keeping them in bounds. But you know, you've got a small space. It's not that much work. You have to have something to do.
Hey, this is perfect spot. Got flat brickwork.
It's just like a patio.
Yeah, fabulous. So what do we need? What did Dana want?
Okay, so Dana wanted food, a fruit tree or something.
Right.
She wanted a place to have people sit and
entertain. The tea party.
Yeah,
the tea party. Right.
And then the screen, the climate, because of the sun coming in.
Right,
so some
kind
of screening
plant
or something.
So we need some stuff. Let's start building.
Okay.
Hey, look what you got.
Look what you got.
I'll see you. I'll meet you back here.
Yeah.
Okay.
Not bad.
Yeah, it's pretty good. Have a seat.
Yeah. You know, it's good.
Yeah.
Something's missing.
I know. Oh, that's perfect. Yeah, nice touch. Okay. Now, one thing missing.
Dana. Dana is missing.
Yeah.
She would love to see this.
Let's bring her back.
How do we do that?
Oh, I got an app for that.
Hydration, fertilization, oh, frustration. Where are those Garden Wise guys when you need them? Whoa.
Hi,
you guys are amazing.
Oh, we got some tricks. Yeah. Let me get this out of your way.
Thanks so much.
Oh, you're welcome. Here's what we did. When we were over at your house, we heard what you said. You like the idea of having the girls over for a tea party, so of course you need a stable surface, you know, table, chairs. That's just kind of fundamental.
And then, oh, you wanted the screening from the morning sun? We got screening. And check this out, an apple tree for free.
And it's a small variety. It'll work fine on your patio. Also, we added just, you know, a few kind of ornamental things. So, you know, we got it started. This is just the basics. This is what you need.
I love it.
Yeah. Great.
You know, I love it so much, but if it isn't too much to ask, I was looking through one of my magazines, and could we add just maybe a little Asian flair?
Yeah, that would be fine.
I saw this thing over
here.
Yeah. I think you'd really like it.
Oh.
You want to? Come on.
Yeah, we could also add a little soy sauce and wasabi and water the plants with it.
So, Dana, this is the Asian section here.
Oh, I love it. Oh, it's so serene. Nice. Thank you.
Sure.
It's missing something. Screening. Bamboo! It's perfect! Owen, could you just grab that and bring it in? I think it's the last thing we need. Maybe a few more plants. Oh, right there. That's great. And I love this water feature.
Yeah.
But I'm worried about the water. Is it too much?
You mean water use?
Yeah.
Oh, no, it recirculates.
Oh!
Yeah, it's not a problem.
Oh, great!
Yeah.
Well, looks pretty good. A Buddha. A giant Buddha. Oh. No. I don't know. It needs something. Oh, what's that? Mediterranean. Billy?
So we've got these other things taken care of. Let's talk a little bit about plants. All of these plants that I have here are from Mediterranean climate regions, so they fit really well in Southern California with our warm, sunny climate. And they come from all over, South Africa, from Mexico, Europe, different Mediterranean areas.
And I noticed the Phlomis fruticosa grande verde.
Whoa! Hey, I think she's got it.
Yes. And the screening. You've got this beautiful citrus tree.
Right.
Sustainable,
right.
Functional, and delicious.
And yeah, it does the screening that you need. Boy, you're really catching on this. And yeah, delicious
We
too.
Just need a few edible plants.
Okay.
Could you pull the card in a little
sure.
bit? Look at these beautiful lettuces.
Yeah.
I could grow these in terracotta pots on my patio.
Exactly.
And look at that globe artichoke.
Yeah.
A native of Mediterranean regions.
Exactly.
You know, Billy, all we need is a little dip.
Ah, there's a mayonnaise plant on the other side here.
Oh,
let's go.
Have a
look. Yeah.
Now look at this, a completely different style garden that would look absolutely fabulous with a contemporary style home. It's less about flowers and more about form and sculptural plants. And look at this simple focal point. Absolutely stunning.
Oh, you know, it also provides a habitat value for the sphagnum flamingo we have here.
I'm going to check in with Owen.
Okay.
Now look at this great selection of pots, which are essential for the small space garden. A small patio, a balcony where you don't have a lot of soil, these would be perfect. Even a large garden where they provide wonderful accents. These pots would be wonderful with a wide variety of drought-tolerant plants, succulents, or even vegetables. And these particular pots are made of natural clay, which will last forever, unless, of course, you break them. Now, Owen, I'm not sure what this is over here.
Yeah, it's a funny-looking pot, huh? Actually, this is a plastic rain barrel, and even on a balcony, you could catch rainwater off the roof through the downspout. It just connects right in there. The water goes into the barrel, and then it goes out through a spigot, and you can water your plants with it off of rainwater. That's sustainable.
That's a great design.
It's good. Now, while we're on the subject of water, you can water pots by hand with, you know, a nozzle like this and a hose, and that's fine. But you can also automate a little bit, and you can put on a drip system. Drip tubing, emitters, a filter and regulator, and you can even put on a little timer that hooks onto this and hooks onto your faucet, and you set it and it shuts itself off. So you can set it in the morning when you go to work or something.
Completely hands-free, no-brainer.
Totally easy.
Set it and you're done.
Nothing to it.
I love it.
Yeah.
Functional and sustainable. Now let's take a look at beauty. Come on, Owen. Now this would be gorgeous on a small patio or even a balcony. It's very sophisticated, and it almost looks like a Japanese flower arrangement. And because it's made of succulents, it requires very little water or maintenance. It's bulletproof.
Owen.
What?
Owen.
What?
Owen.
She's incredibly good.
I know she's doing. I don't know. I just hope she doesn't bump us out of the ratings. I don't want to be the next Conan O'Brien. Yeah.
This is Dana, the GardenWise gal. Join me next time where I'll discuss the benefits of raising miniature livestock in your very own living room. And by the way, didn't Owen and Billy do a great job?